Ụfọdụ ga-asị na mụ mụrụ kaị, ụfọdụ ga-asị na mụ mụrụ n'ụkaị kaị, mana ha amaghị ije mụ na Chimaye. Topic today: understanding the force of divine alignment. I think the coordinator and my sisters that gave open chat initially, they've enlightened us about alignment. So I don't want to go to that. Today, the spirit leads me to let us understand the meaning of force. Force, understanding, and divine. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What is force? Force is something that is pushful, that makes something to break open, to break loose. It's something that forces another thing to have an impact on an object, and it creates an effect. In physics, force is mass times acceleration. So in our lives, the mass is the load we carry. And this load, acceleration, is the people, the trouble around you, the catalyst, the bothering albumin around it that will make you, that will push you, people will push you, situations will push you, and then, my brothers and sisters, you will start asking, where is my God? And we have types of forces. Force at a distance and direct force. So God uses both electromagnetic and force, frictional force, to bring you to where he wants you to be. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So divine is something from above. So what is understanding? Abumoni onimobodo. Ngota. Ngota. Comprehension. Cognizance. Knowledge. Assimilation. Absorption. I really understand. And there is a difference between understanding. It won't be easy. And to your greatest surprise, it may come from people you trust. It may come from people you like so much. It may come from things you don't even expect. But watch and see. My brothers and sisters, I want us to take a reflection. There are people in the Bible that are products of divine alignment. We know Joseph. If you go to Genesis 30, from verse 14, Rachel was the one that Jacob wanted to marry. But because of the tradition, the elder one must go before the younger one. So the father asked Jacob to serve another year so that he can get Rachel. And God purposely closed the womb of Rachel. And Reuben, in verse 14, went and got mandrakes. Brother Mike explained mandrakes before. Something that is sweet smelling. Humility. Rachel is the younger one. She went to her sister. Please, can you give me this mandrake? And she exchanged for her tongue of the night. And in verse 22, we heard what happened. Sequence upon sequence. And Joseph, the child of destiny, was born. And that's why Joseph means, you have removed reproach from me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you go to Genesis 30, 14, 15, 22. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. In Genesis 37, Joseph had a dream in verse 6. He had a dream. He told his brothers, I had a dream that you will serve me. He is the younger ones. But he said, you will serve me. And they became jealous. You see where I'm coming from. So that when something happens outside, when it can even happen with your own siblings, do not take it too far. Because God is trying to take you to a destination. You will later be on the rock. In Psalm 40 verse 1 to 2, he had delivered me and blessed me on a high mountain. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And instead of selling Joseph, the brother Judah said, let's not kill our brother. Let's not have blood in our hand. Instead, let's sell him. They sold him. If he was not a child of destiny, they would have took him or killed him on the way. But they sold him to a royal family, Potiphar's family. The rest of the story, if you go to verse 41, 38, he was exalted. We know of Jacob. How that Rebecca played a part. If you go to Genesis 18:22, verse 9, it says, "Woe betide me if I don't fulfill what I said." We know mothers. God positioned Jacob to be blessed. So the mother overheard the father saying he wants to bless. So he positioned Jacob to receive that blessing, because God has, and we know the story of Jacob, it wasn't easy. But what happened? The Lord blessed him. I want us to go to Ruth before I come to myself. I want us to go to Ruth. We know what happened to Ruth. In Ruth chapter 1 from verse 14, Orpah, the co-wife of Ruth, said, when they lost their husband, "I'm leaving. I came here, no child, nothing. I'm leaving." But Ruth said, "Mama, my mother-in-law," in verse 16, "where you go, I will go. Your people shall be my people." And in verse 20, Naomi said, "My name is no longer Mara. My name is Mara, bitterness, sorrow, because the Lord left me empty-handed. I went to this land full, but now I'm returning empty-handed. I am an outcast, I'm nobody." But you don't know what God is planning. Yes. It is the same Naomi that positioned Ruth. If you go to Ruth, verse 2, when you're going to 14, Boaz said, "I have known your patience, endurance, and at such a time, a kinsman redeemer." Somebody that was supposed to buy everything his husband has will also buy him. And in verse 6, Ruth 4, verse 6, the kinsman redeemer said, "I can't buy this one, because God knows that Ruth that Jesus will come from her generation." See the endurance. Yes, so what are the ways to align ourselves? Number one is humility. Being humble. Number two is listening to the Holy Ghost. Listening to the Holy Ghost. Children, listen to your mom. We know what happened. When Rebecca positioned Jacob to be blessed. Obedience, perseverance, Ruth persevered. In Romans 3:5, your perseverance brings hope, and hope brings endurance, and hope does not fail us. Pursuing your course, Ruth pursued her course. I have a story for myself, about myself. Yes, in my office, because this product of divine alignment, I'm a typical example. Where I got a job, I was from Nigeria. They said, "Who said, sister, if you want to teach me anything, teach me. I am humble to learn." And she's not comfortable with blood bank. I went that last 2 weeks. So when God is aligning you, those forces will come. But when those forces come, take it serious. Pray. Just pray. It may weaken you. You will hear things that you don't want. But God is taking you to a higher place. My brothers and sisters, it was so hard. It was so hard when they look at you. The people that have worked 5 years, and me that just came. I went into my knees. I said, "God, manifest yourself." Last 2 weeks, they set a spy, a gossip, to work with me. In the morning, the lady made mistake, used another person's sample against another person. So they were thinking it was me. When the mistake came, it was them. They fell into the pit they dug for themselves. So the confession the girl gave, "I didn't know you're this good." They were saying, I said, "You don't know my God. You don't know my God." On Thursday, I worked with my director. He said, in the morning, "I didn't listen to the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost told me, work as if you're alone. Do not ask him anything. I will teach you." I went to throw even the trash that day. I will from trash. Before he left, even before that, he told me, "Isn't I see you're good? You can handle the lab. You are good." Honestly, no one pastor. Divine alignment. Force, push. To the glory of God. To the only respect and accusation now. I have cross-matched at least 10 pints of blood, and no patient has died. But somebody last week, they said she doesn't amount anything. Force of divine alignment. I worked by myself the whole of last week and today, and I came today. So when God is trying to position you, Okay, come and get ready in Zion. Ewo, iku kwama no ya bagie. Hala baba. Oye, were ihe nile. Ewo. Oye, bili miri na nonu ya. We dere ju ezema. Oye, na sepere bagie. Odoguo, rigoro ni megi.